just in case you guys didn't already know, I'm actually beginning to intern. Not really sure if you can call it an internship, but I am kind of working with a family friend who's a psychologist, a doctor, psychologist, speech therapist. She wears many hats and she does this group therapy, so I can't really video anything in the group therapy itself, but I do help out with other things. So what I'll do is just I have been kind of videotaping little bits and pieces over there to give you guys a little bit of a glimpse as to what that is like. And yeah, most of the kids there are special needs kids, so yeah, that's kind of why I don't really want to ask whether I can film like the actual group sessions. But it is very, very interesting, and she's a very, very smart woman, duh. So, shall see you guys soon. This is the job I'm in right now. I am actually preparing all of the activities and the materials for all the different classes. So yeah, this is what I'm doing. Got all of the long time since I haven't used a pair of scissors. And I get to use a laminating machine. How cool is that? That's off now. I've already laminated everything here. Then I need to cut them out again. So I actually have to cut them out from the originals and then laminate them here. This one, the chat already. So yeah, this is what I'm going to be helping out with for the next couple months. So this is the footage from the farewell party that we just had recently with the kids. I did get the consent from the doctor that I'm working with to film it, so I made sure to just not include any of their faces, and if we mention names, I made sure to get rid of that as well. It was really, really fun, and they were all very, very cute and very, very active. So yeah, hope you guys enjoy it.
Hey, middle, you must spin it again, spin it again. Oh,
I told you it's predictive.
Okay, please definitely. Oh! Oh! You're out. But just now you just shake the tail.
You already done it so
much. It's only a toy. It's not even real.
Let it go. Let it go. Let it go now. I gave you good advice.
Yeah.
So that was the first few sessions, I think it was the first week or two of me actually working with this doctor. I'm just gonna refer to her as Miss, just to like keep her identity confidential as well, I guess. It's been a really, really refreshing experience because I've never actually worked with high functioning special needs kids before. So previously when I worked with them, they were rather young, yeah, not very, very old kids. And most of them have quite severe autism, so they were not very high functioning kids. They were quite low functioning. So most of them did not have speech. So it was very, very difficult for us to communicate because I wasn't sure how much they could understand me, and I definitely couldn't understand them because they couldn't really talk to me. So even teaching them basic skills like, you know, writing or even talking, it was a very, very big challenge. So we were very, very focused on extremely low levels of functioning and teaching. So simple things, again, as simple as talking, had to be taught, and, you know, going to the restroom, very, very basic living skills. However, most of these classes, like I said, most of them are high functioning special needs kids. So the things that we're teaching them are actually like social skills, actually something that Miss refers to as social thinking. Now, this was a huge culture shock for me because I had never been able to even get past, like I said, basic living skills. And these kids have such amazing vocabulary. They have such personalities. It's very, very refreshing, very funny, and they really keep you engaged. They keep me on my toes, definitely. Because like I said, they have different personalities. They're quiet ones. They're very, very talkative ones. And they're ones who are very, very cheeky as well. So just wonderful to just see them so developed, for lack of a better term, so developed. And what Miss is actually doing is that she's actually teaching them ways to enter society in terms of, like, again, social thinking. So it's not so much as like such a deadpan social skill in the sense that, oh, when you talk, you need to use eye contact, or you need to greet people when you walk into a room, or greet strangers and stuff like that. So it's not so one-track mind, because like if you can just remember that skill, then like takkan like always looking at you when they're talking. So she's actually going a step further in teaching them how to actively think in different types of social situations, how to actively think when they're interacting with other people. And the reason she can do is because that these kids, number one, have been with her for quite a while, and they are just so smart. Like, to me, they're so smart. Vocabulary is amazing. Most of them are actually in first classes in their schools. Not to say all, I don't want to generalize, but I knew a few that were in actually top classes in their schools, and they do very, very well for themselves. They have pretty good IQs, and again, doing very well in school. Some of them play piano, as you saw, play very, very well in fact, and they're so young. So it's a very, very big learning curve for me, because to me it's like I can see so much hope for the future, because as I said, when I worked outside, I had mainly only dealt with lower functioning kids, and I live with my uncle, my mom's brother, who is also Down syndrome. And again, he's very, very low functioning. So he's about 40 plus this year, and he doesn't have speech. So it was very tough to communicate with him as well. And he's highly, highly dependent. So that was always my outlook on like special needs kids, is that, oh my gosh, it's kind of like, we need to take care of them forever, and they won't be able to learn how to be independent themselves, which scares me as well, not only for us the caretakers, but also for them. And to see Miss be able to teach them so much and kind of like push them beyond their limit, push them to achieve even more, give them more and more tools to put in their toolbox, it is very heartwarming for me for many reasons. For one reason is that there is somebody who cares this much about them, and who has the skill set and the knowledge to actually equip them with these tools. And number two is just to see that hope that they are able to go out into society, hold jobs themselves in future, and kind of like be independent. It gives me a lot of hope to see that. And third is actually to see how happy they are as individuals, because I'm sure that they get picked on in school, and again, like, special needs kids, especially for people with like autism and all, they tend to get picked on in school, so the depression and anxiety rates are higher. So yeah, it's very heartwarming to see them smile and laugh so much while they're in these group therapies with Miss, and to see them interacting with each other as well. It really, really brings a lot of warmth to my heart. So yeah, this is what I've learned thus far, is that these kids can actually learn so much more, and that there are people out there who have the skill set to help them, which is, again, is why I love psychology so much, because there are different fields of psychology for like everybody. You don't need to be, again, I keep on hearing people like, oh, like I don't need to see a therapist, I'm not crazy, or like I'm not psycho, I'm not insane. There's so much more to psychology than that, and I really, really hope and pray that everybody will be able to see this, because from special needs kids who need attention in social skills, all the way to people who are clinically depressed, and everybody in between, even somebody who wants to improve their well-being, improve their positive thinking, and improve kind of like life satisfaction, stress, or like decrease stress at work, psychology has an answer for so many things, in my opinion. And since most of my work experience in psychology up until today has mainly been with children, I'm learning so much about kids who are low functioning and high functioning, and how to deal with them differently, very, very different ways of dealing with them, and kind of like how to help them and how to prepare them for what's coming. So thank you so much for tuning in to this episode of Just In Time. I don't think I did an intro for this because I'm kind of changing it into like a vlogging type of thing where I'm showing you a bit of my life as well and talking. So hopefully it's not so boring for you guys. And I would really, really love to hear your feedback, your input, positive criticism, hopefully positive. But definitely give me your ideas, what you guys like to see and what you guys want to see more of. And yeah, I really, really like interacting with you guys. So thank you guys for tuning in to this episode. See you.